It's late May and we're here in the Lake Elkhorn Community Garden in Columbia, Maryland. And I'd like to show you some of the very productive and attractive raised beds that this one gardener has put together in a 20 by 25 foot plot. Within this one little area, there are probably 14 separate raised beds. Raised beds are very popular with gardeners. They help to define your gardening space. They also keep you from walking in the garden where we would compact the soil. Raised beds allow us to focus all of our attention in these defined spaces so that our watering, our fertilizing is in the garden and not in the walkways. And raised beds are above ground level. We're increasing the depth of the soil so that the roots have more room to mine the soil for nutrients and water. So in this garden, we have raised beds of different sizes and different depths. Most of them are 8 inches high or above soil level. Some are 10 inches above. And they're made with untreated lumber. I would estimate that these will last 8 or 10 years being untreated. If they were painted, they would last maybe 5 or 6 years longer. The latex paint would provide a protective coating that would limit the rotting of the boards. The construction of these raised beds is pretty straightforward. This gardener nailed the end boards to the side boards, first drilling a pilot hole where each nail was going to go. You can also use galvanized wood screws or decking screws. Very simple and will give plenty of support. Raised beds are usually 2 feet to 4 feet wide, and the idea is that you can comfortably work around the beds and across the beds without stepping into them. This is a beautiful example of raised beds without any enclosures. There's no wood, no bricks, no stone holding the soil. The gardener simply pulled the soil up into a raised bed shape, leveled it off at the top. The soil here is about 6 inches above grade level, and she'll maintain this form throughout the growing season. Very attractive and very productive. Here's an example of a unique raised bed made out of bamboo poles. It's about 7 feet long, 6 feet wide. Good example of using the materials that are at hand. Be resourceful, and you can come up with something as interesting as this bamboo raised bed. Here's another unique raised bed garden made with 2-inch by 8-inch boards. And you can see the soil is quite rich. And one of the ways gardeners get this type of high quality soil in a raised bed is to use the existing soil plus the topsoil from the walkways between the raised beds plus a lot of organic matter. Now, if your soil is very poor, you can simply build your raised bed, set it on the ground, and then fill it with a mixture of topsoil and compost. And these mixtures are available from commercial suppliers around the U.S.